So I had one simple question that I wrote out and I put on a sticky in my dining room. Why has it been 76 years since Lou Gehrig has died and there is no treatment? I've been sent home to basically die on my own in this day and age. Why is that the case? The thing that I was shocked at the most right away was that in ALS, we were the most fractured group, second most fractured fundraising group in the entire United States. So we came up with ALS One, you know, one team, something that represented Boston, represented what we're trying to do here, but represent the unity of one group, bringing the family and friends together first. Because that inner circle starts with anybody connected to this disease. When I'm not here, the secret to this, to me, is to build this program, build this team, and get these people to work together. And I think that's gonna be the glue that when I'm not here anymore, it carries forward. Because I don't wanna start something and then it dies off. We need it to have momentum. And if we're gonna find a treatment or a cure, my money is it's gonna come out of the medical Silicon Valley of the world.
Everything's just right, yeah, except for one thing. You should be here, standing with your arm around me here, and cutting up, cracking a cold beer, saying cheers. Hey y'all, it's sure been a good year. It's one of those moments that's got your name written all over it. And you know that if I had just one wish, it'd be that you didn't have to miss this. You should be here.
What Kevin Gosnell has accomplished in assembling this all-star team of researchers, doctors, and ALS advocates is nothing short of amazing.
I was delighted to get involved with ALS One through the charismatic entreaties of Kevin Gosnell, whom we all deeply admire and deeply miss.
I got into the field of ALS because of the excitement and the hope for making a difference for people with this illness.
When I met the ALS research team, I was blown away by their compassion and their drive to really figure out this disease that has affected so many wonderful people and wonderful families.
So to be a mother who is told that your son has a disease, that there's no treatment, no cure, and he only has 2 to 5 years to live, probably the worst day of my life, the day that Pete was no longer gonna call me mom. And then to leave that office and not really understand what the reality of what this disease was about to do.
My dad was the healthiest guy I've ever seen, and my dad, ironically, was born on the day that Lou Gehrig died of ALS. 75 years later and there's no cure and no medication. Everything we can do with ALS One, volunteering and stuff like that.
Kevin always said that this disease is curable. We just need enough people to care.
ALS One has a tremendous team. We will not die. We will reach Kevin's goals. We will have a treatment or a cure by 2020 with improved care now.
You just need enough people to care. And for still tonight, Kevin is leading us in support of ALS One to finally make ALS done.
All right, I got 10,000 going once, 10,000 going twice. Sold to the good looking man.
Really focus on and think about is that relationship. It's the most valuable thing there is. You know, the relationship with your wife, with your kids, and your friends. It is so important. And when I'm
in bed and I'm at the end, my last breaths. I want to make sure that I've done everything I can do to squeeze the juice out of those relationships. That's the secret right there. It's not how much we make or all that stuff. I always tell my kids, at the end of the day, a real man's judged by what he gives. That's it. What have you given back during the course of your life? How have you helped? That's the real judge. You know, sometimes I have a dream. The dream that this somehow reversed. And just the difference I could make would be staggering. That's one thing I wish.
Should be.